Hi YouTube, it's Alyssa, and today I'm going to be doing a video on my belly button. I've wanted to do this video for like 3 weeks now, ever since I got it done. And you guys wanted it really badly, so I thought, why not just do this video now? It's better than never, right? So when I went to get my piercing done, I got my friend to take a video of it, so I'm going to show you guys that right now.
It doesn't hurt.
It doesn't hurt.
Yeah.
What the heck?
See, it doesn't hurt.
But the clamp does hurt more.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, you're
pretty cool tattoo. All the wings and everything.
I don't know if you guys could tell from that video, but it didn't hurt that bad. And I decided to take your guys' questions from Instagram to answer some of your questions on the whole experience and just the belly button in total. The most commonly asked question about the whole belly button piercing is, does it hurt? And I guess this is different for everyone, but for me, it didn't hurt at all. The only thing that hurt was the clamp, which also didn't hurt. It just felt like a pinch, like a really hard pinch. How much does it cost? It cost about, for me, it cost $80, $90, but that's because you want to go to somewhere where people are experienced at what they're doing and you'll be sure to like, that you'll like it and not regret getting it. Do you like it? I love it so, so much. It's probably my favorite piercing I've ever gotten. I've only gotten my ears pierced, so this is definitely a big change and I do really like it. In the healing process, what did you need to do to prevent it to get infected? I had to use this thing called Bactine. It's a spray bottle. You can get it at the like grocery store for people in the States. You can get it at Walgreens. You just spray it on the area and then you move your belly button piercing around, like up and down. I don't know if you can see this. Look at, you just go and you move it up and down. Yep. And then you also can use a Q-tip if you're too scared to move it up and down, because you know it might not be as like movable as mine. You can take a Q-tip and just kind of like dust it all around and go. Yes, that is how you do it. When can you start doing things, as in swimming, traveling, such like that? It depends. You're not supposed to go into a swimming pool until 2 weeks after you've got it done. You're not supposed to go into a hot tub until 6 months. You're not supposed to change it until like 7 months. You just have to be cautious with it. To be completely honest, whatever you feel is best for yourself. So if you feel like you can't go in a pool after 2 weeks, don't do it. If you feel like you can't go in a hot tub after 6 months, don't do it. Simply go by your own thing, just don't make it any shorter. Another question is, how long did it take to convince your parents? It took me forever. It took me like a year, 2 years. I don't know, I've wanted it for so long, so I've always asked. And then my dad finally let me. Like, my mom was like, okay, you can like get your piercing as long as your dad says yes. So my dad said no, 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 no. And then he was like yes one day, and I was like, oh cool. He didn't love it, but you know, he said yes, so yeah. Those are the main questions that I got. I just want to say my whole healing process, because mine went so well and I don't understand why. But I thought I'd tell you guys it because it might give you guys a better feeling for what it could be like for you. Like, it's different for everyone, but mine healed actually like so well. So hopefully this makes you like, if you're wanting to get one, it'll make you guys go, ooh, I really want one now. So when I got mine done, it didn't hurt at all. And then I went to a river with my friends and it was fine. You know, everything was all good. I didn't go in the river or anything because I was too scared to. And I had to go camping and there was a pool of course there, and I went in the pool. So it was of course before the 2 weeks have ended, and I suggest you don't do this, but yeah, I went in the pool and it was fine. It's because I thought it would be fine for myself because mine was healing so well. Usually you can't move it up and down the second day, and I started playing with it and moving it up and down, and usually you can't do that. So I decided I'll go in the pool and then just clean it after. And then I also went in a hot tub and it's fine still. It hasn't gotten infected. It hasn't had any problems. Of course it's gonna pus and it's going to scab a little bit, but honestly that's just the part of healing. It might feel kind of itchy sometimes when it's in the healing process, but that is all gone, and it feels like I've had this piercing for like a year now when it's only been like 3 weeks. But yeah, I suggest you don't go in a pool before your 2 weeks have ended, and don't go into a hot tub until your 6 months has been up, because it's probably not a good idea, but I did it because mine healed so amazing. But yeah, it's really cool now. I don't know if you can see this. It looks like this. It looks really weird right now. It's kind of red because I've been playing with it. But yeah, that's it about my video, my belly button. That's about all you need to know. So, bye. Hi, people that are still here at the end of the video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and let's try to get to 500 likes. That'd be super rad if you're new to my channel. Hi, my name's Alyssa. I make videos on this channel almost every week. If you want, you can check out my other videos. There's one right below me. And then you can also just subscribe to me to be notified when I get a new video. So that's cool. You can also follow me on my social medias, which will either be on that side or that side. And that'd be super cool. I'm really active on Twitter and Instagram. So yeah. I'll see you guys next week. Bye.